Hello and welcome to KSD Podcast. In this session and in the next few sessions, I would be talking about the changes that have been made in the various central laws by way of promulgation of ordinances under the terms of Article 123 of the Constitution. In this session, I would be discussing in brief about the corporate insolvency resolution process under the terms of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016 and the changes that have been effected through the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance 2020. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance 2020 was promulgated on 5th June 2020, amending the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016. The code provides a time-bound process for resolving insolvency in companies and among individuals. Insolvency is a situation where individuals or companies are unable to repay their outstanding debt. The ordinance aims to exempt certain companies from the provisions of the code with respect to initiation of a corporate insolvency resolution process. When a default occurs, the creditors of the company or the company itself may file an application before the National Company Law Tribunal for initiating corporate insolvency resolution process. Once the application is accepted, a committee of creditors is constituted consisting of financial creditors of the company. The committee of creditors appoints a resolution professional who manages the resolution process and presents a resolution plan to the committee of creditors. Once the resolution plan is approved, the resolution process is required to be completed within 180 days, which is extendable by 90 days. During the resolution, if it is found that the business of the company is being carried out with an intent to defraud its creditors, the National Company Law Tribunal can pass orders against persons involved in such business to make contributions to the assets of the company. Further, the resolution professional can apply to the National Company Law Tribunal for an order to direct the director or the partner of the company to make such contributions if before the insolvency date the director or the partner knew or should have known that there was no reasonable prospect of avoiding corporate insolvency resolution process, or the director or the partner did not exercise due diligence to minimize the potential loss to the creditors of the company. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance 2020 exempts certain companies from the provisions on initiation of corporate insolvency resolution process. It states that an application for the same cannot be filed where a default has arisen during a period of at least 6 months starting from 25th March 2020. The central government may extend this period to 1 year through notification. The ordinance clarifies that no proceedings can ever be initiated for defaults occurring during this period. The ordinance further states that for such companies, the resolution professional cannot file an application to the National Company Law Tribunal for directions against the partners or the directors of the company to make contributions to the assets of the company. So this, in a nutshell, was all about the changes that have been made in the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code through the amendment via the ordinance route. Thank you very much.